Hello guys, today I'm gonna do a little breakdown of my gun. This is Rise Amoeba 013. It comes with a decent packet box. This nice looking guy with the micro aimpoint. This look interesting. I have it over here, right here. This is the box, and behind the box you'll find the magazine option. You can find it in the store. And for more information, you can visit the site. And it comes with a nice looking manual. This is AM013 Airsoft Assault Rifle Electronic Firing Control System. Let's take a look. It's only one piece of paper. See, for your information, you have noticed this gun is not metal. And the upper is in two piece upper receiver. So it might a little bit different with another AG out there, and unfortunately I don't have the magazine that come with it, so I cannot describe about the magazine. But let's start with the gun. With the gun itself, it has these two iron sack. Okay, let's start with the gun. The gun itself come with two iron sight, and you might notice this as a Troy battle sight, but it's not. It's a plastic, it's a fake. You can see the marking over here. I don't know if you can see this, but it says Toys Industries, not Troy Industries. And it's plastic, it's a fake. Comes with another two additional rail. You can attach it to your front grip, and because maybe you can attach a flashlight or laser sight over here, but I don't think I need it right now, so I will reattach that thing. I'm sorry. You just need a proper Allen key. Take this off. Okay. And this hand stop. Okay, this has a small buttstock. Can attach it by depress this two button over here, and to detach this buttstock you only need to press this way right here. And this is the battery, it's so small. I've already changed it with DIN connector. We'll take a look inside right here. Small right here, and to take a look at the inside of this receiver, you only need to take out this pin. It's quite simple. That you have the pin gone, and only need to take this like that and push your chamber and your barrel, and you'll have your upper and lower separate. Like so. See. Nice pink cylinder. Quite good. Decent gearbox. Take this side. And first, let's take a look at the upper receiver and the front guard. As I said before, it has two pieces, so it connects this, the left side and the right side, to the outer right here. Oh yeah, this is the chamber and the inner barrel. It has a black inner barrel, I don't know, maybe it's just the factory in it. It says that this is 0.03, unlike the standard inner barrel that comes with another AG. It has also nice chamber out here. Usually you have to turn the hop up right here, but it has nice, so you can do it when it's right here. I'll show you. It's easier to adjust the hop up. See, you pull the charging handle and you have nice little wheel right here. Easier to change the hop up. And the next one, you take this aside. And how to detach this thing? It's very easy. Pretty simple. You need to detach this. You need to turn it counterclockwise. I scratched this for the first time when I tried to open this. This. All you need to do is take this off. Get the proper Allen key. It's only this. See? And voila! You have the nice front guard. Made out of metal. With the under rail, and this is the outer barrel. It's empty. You can see nothing inside here. And this is the barrel nut. If you want to take out the outer barrel, and maybe you change this, I don't know. I never do this because it's still stuck. You can take this off and change it to the another outer barrel, maybe, I don't know. Okay, that's about the upper and the front thing, and this now the gearbox. To take the gearbox out, you have to take the motor and the buttstock over here, the battery place. The proper Allen key to open this key inside here. For here, maybe if you can see it. Let me do this outside the camera. See, when you have one screw over here to screw it to the gearbox. Take this off and might have a little bit problem when you try to take this off, because I cut the tin connector a bit so it can through this little hole over here, so you can easily take this off from the lower receiver. And next we have to take this off. Okay. Now you can see the wiring and the motor. We'll try to take it off. And this is motor. It's like stuck to something. I'll do this out of the camera. Okay, I finally take off the motor. This is the motor. You can see it's stand pretty standard. Not so good magnet over here. You can lift the dynamo with the motor with the screwdriver. It's okay. You have this. You have to take this grip. It has four screw, you know, four screw. This one. So after you've loosened the four screw over here, you can take this grip out. Take this off slowly so you won't hurt the cable. Take this out. And you'll have the gearbox and the lower receiver. Take this off so it won't distract you. And to lose this gearbox, you have to remove these two pin over here. That seems really hard. Okay, got one over here. Finally take this off and you need to take this off. Oh, I forgot one thing. This is the magazine release. Put the proper screw to this fit. Yes, it's nice. Easily unscrew this thing and it's loose. Okay, last thing, might wanna take this to single. This might bother you. Okay, just take this box out of the lower receiver. It's pretty hard for the first time. Just pull it out like so. Just pull this thing. Let me do this out of the camera. Okay. Cut this just like this. So nice. I don't want to take this off because it still has this, and you can see as what I said, using electronic trigger control you can hear the clicking sound. A quite different mod tablet plate. Let me clean this up. Using 8 mm pushing or whatever you call it. Oh yes, it's using a quick change spring. You will need to find the correct Allen key over here to take this cover up, and you can take the spring out of the gearbox and change with something. Will be, oh yeah, this is clock around 380 FPS, so it might be higher for some field, so you can change the lower spring and easily without taking this gearbox out. I mean, take this gearbox apart. So this, I don't really understand about this, but it's quite good technology. Still has a plastic nozzle, full cylinder, 7 mm piercing, and good wiring, I guess. And this wire outside the gearbox, so pretty nice. So it doesn't bother your gear or something when you take this out, take this apart. Okay, now to take this in. Like so, then right here, like this. Oh, forgot the cap. Don't know what's that for, but it's there, so I will put it there. Okay, easier than you think. So you can do otherwise. To first take, put this nice and comfort magazine release. Like this. I'm sorry. Oops. Maybe I'll just put this here. Back in. What the? This thing. Okay. Got it. Nice and easy. And pin. Make sure you put it the thing over here to the last part you insert it, like just like so. Like this. Give a little punch. That nicely, and this pin, like that. Oops. Oh yeah, don't push this pin too far. It will make your lower receiver to bend. So don't do this hard too hard. Let's check this out. Oh, don't forget this fake bolt catch. Just like that. Now the grip. The grip. It has four screws over here. This one is here. Okay. So this is, it has two over here. It's in front and the back. Seems. So you take this in. I'm sorry. This is here. This is here. Quite simple, then you screw it back. All the four screw to the gearbox from the grip. Okay. Now you can take the motor. It's the my motor. Motor over here. So because the red is over here, so just like this. Make sure the spring is working when you put this motor on, just like this. Then you can put this thing back. Red to red, black to black. Like so. Then take this heatsink in. Hold this. Oh, I forgot. Just put it in. Forgot which one in the front and the back. Oops. Okay. After that, you can take this battery compartment again, like this, and screw it back. Use the proper Allen key. Oops. Do it out of the camera. Okay, finally got this one. Yeah, the battery compartment cap. Don't pull it back. I mean, pull it good like this. This in the top, in the bottom like this. Nicely. And let's take the upper receiver again. This. To take it on. You have to align this. Oh, I'm sorry. Put the inner barrel and the chamber first. Okay, pull it nicely. Just spring so it will release like this. And to take it off, I mean to take it on, put it back on. You have to do it right here. Do a little push. I'm sorry, it's just stuck. Okay. Do a little push to your chamber. Then, after you align this correctly, you put the pin back, your front pin, just like this. Let's see. Now, take the. Let's put this front again. See, it's better like this. Don't put it upside down. Just like that. Remember, we only have one screw over here. And it has the ring on it. It has ring. And take the proper Allen key. Screw it tight because it's only this screw that hold the front and the upper, the whole body. Okay, almost finished. You can take this in, screw it back in clockwise. Okay, it's hold tight. And the last thing is this, you depress this two button over here in the battery compartment and pull it back like so. Then you have your gun Rise and MOBA complete, disassemble and reassemble. And that's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope this is helping you, and goodbye.